Thomas Chippendale, the premier furniture maker of the 18th century, evokes images of unparalleled elegance due to his ingenious designs and perfect execution. Throughout his lifetime, he received commissions from regal clientele, including Catherine II of Russia and English nobility. He was the first cabinet maker to have an entire style bear his own name. Chippendale's 1754 book, The Gentleman and Cabinet Maker's Director, is considered the Bible of furniture design, still to this day. Unfortunately, Chippendale was never truly compensated for his craftsmanship, and he is one of the few masters who died bankrupt. With his use of the finest timbers with rich, warm patinas, and his ability to emphasize the beauty of wood, his pieces are considered works of art and are found in the world's most important museums.
Hello, I'm Bill Rao from MS Rao New Orleans. What we have here is something wonderful, something very special. It is a desk by the great man himself, Thomas Chippendale. And even in the world of Chippendale furniture, desks have always held a special place. There are no more than five original desks made by Thomas Chippendale himself. And this example is one of them. So what makes this desk so special? The wood is most beautiful Cuban mahogany. Every bit about it is exceptional. Let me show you how it works. So the desk itself is what's known as a library desk. It's higher than a normal desk. What makes it higher? I mean, obviously because we have this superstructure on top of the drawers. And this would have been a great place to put books or to lay out pieces if you wanted to stand and look at something. But of course, most people wanted to sit and do their work. So of course, it would open. And when it would open, it becomes the scale of a regular desk. But of course, you have this border around it. We could open it here, and it becomes the scale of a regular desk for one to sit on. This, of course, comes off. Let's say you want to read. You could put your book right here and read your book. The desk still has its original bays. That's amazing. This is 250 years old. One never sees this. The hinges are what's known as a double hinge. This is something that was only used by Thomas Chippendale himself. Chippendale used mahogany on the inside of the drawer. Whereas almost every other cabinet maker, if they were making something, they would have dovetailed the front of the drawer, but they would have nailed the back of the drawer. This back of the drawer is dovetailed. It costs more money to do it, but it lasted longer. It was sturdier. Whereas virtually every other cabinet maker of the day would have used brass handles and then just maybe put a lacquer over them, Chippendale used brass handles and had them fire gilded. And there's still traces of the fire gilding on there. When you look at the bottom of the desk, first look at the casters. The casters are not set on each corner, they're inset and they roll 360 degrees on grooves. That is something that Chippendale had made for himself. This is so rare to find these original casters. And also, you see this pinkish wash on there? This was known as the Chippendale wash. Chippendale would put these on most of his pieces because it inhibited bugs from getting into the furniture. Every bit about this extraordinary desk is a higher quality than anything else you'll ever see, and it helps to understand why pieces made by Thomas Chippendale are so desired.